I stumbled onto some great artwork on a website called society6.com by an artist called replaceface. The artist photoshopped a bunch of famous faces onto some old paintings. The images are very nicely done, and it would be fun to hang a print of General Bill Murray on my wall. The original paintings were done by George Dawe, an English artist who did 329 portraits of Russian generals during Napoleon's invasion of Russia in the 1700s. I decided I'd like to put my own head on one of these paintings. So a quick Google image search for George Dawe and filtering for the larger images, I found my general. So I saved the image to my desktop and then opened it in Photoshop. Then I found a photograph of myself where my head had a similar orientation. If you want a perfect portrait, then you should set up your lighting to mimic the painting you've chosen. My photo's lighting is backward, but it will still work for this demonstration. The quick selection tool is a great way to do a fast, rough cutout of your head. Then I like to use the polygonal lasso with the Alt key. That way I can subtract my selection where this quick selection tool had grabbed too much. Here I'm holding down the Alt key the entire time. That way I can remove my neck from the selection. It's also nice to hold down the space key so you can pan around and use the control plus, control minus keys to zoom in and zoom out. You can see here I'm continuing to clean up the edge of the selection with the polygonal lasso tool. Now I can just copy the selection from my image and paste it into the old painting image. Now you can immediately see, however, that the scale of my head doesn't match up. That's easily fixed. All you have to use is the Control-T or Free Transform tool. Just make sure you hold down the Shift key to lock the proportion as you scale it. Otherwise, you'll get kind of a squished head. Another nice trick that you can do to ensure the alignment of your head on top of the old head is to adjust the opacity of your head layer. That way you can kind of see if your eyes line up and your mouth and the scale of your and rotation of your head is close enough or accurate. The next step is I need to cut off the old head. And to do this, I use the rubber stamp tool. We have a nice background in this image to rubber stamp from. So make sure you select the background image and hold down the Alt key and start rubber stamping, which is sort of copying that little circular area. You can increase or decrease the size of that area with the little bracket symbols, which are just right of the P key on your keyboard. Now I go back to my head layer and I want to just sort of adjust the overall brightness and contrast of my head to somewhat be similar to the image. Now for the cool part, we apply an artistic filter called the dry brush. And in my particular case, the scale of my image, I found that the brush size of 0 and a brush detail of 10 and a texture of 1 looked pretty close. And the last thing I wanted to do, I felt the level still didn't quite pop the right amount. So I usually like to play with the levels last here to bring in the edges, make the darks just the right amount and the lights just the right amount and the midpoint the right amount. Whenever I use a filter or a process tool, I always like at the end, I like to toggle the preview. That way I can kind of confirm that I didn't actually, the tool I used actually did improve the image. And here's the finished result. Looks pretty cool. You know, if I wanted to spend a lot more time on it, I think I could make it even better. Obviously, I'd get a better photo without a hat and better lighting, but the result's pretty convincing. Thanks for watching and subscribe.